So the reason why males and females exist is for the joy of God and man. Males and females share the letters males, which equals joy. And then when you say males and females, that adds more fives in the middle, no less 15 plus 10 plus 5 in order, three teams of five going down in fives, okay? Done. I've just revealed to you the mind of God on why. And this applies, of course, not just to humans made in the image of God, but all the species, males and females, okay? It's all for God's joy and your joy as well, okay? Done. And, of course, an anagram of that is meals, okay? All the meals of your life and of all species, meals equals joy. And then, best of all, the root, and then Salem, okay? Which is the root of the city of Jerusalem. Jerusalem is love, joy, in order. Jeru, love, Salem, joy. But you find the origin of that word way back in the book of Genesis, okay? Where Jesus Christ appears, Jesus Christ, the second member of the triune God, okay, appears in human form to Abraham as Melchizedek, which means king of righteousness, from the city of Salem, okay? Salem, which equals joy, which means peace, okay? So divine. And but that city ultimately, many years later, becomes Jerusalem in the sovereignty of God, which is love, peace, and love, joy, and order, the first two fruits of the Spirit. And then if you're really good, peace is on the very end of Jerusalem, Lem. So you literally, in Jerusalem, you literally have this love, joy, peace, order. But, and we've had a ton of words from the Lord that all divide by five to go along with this whole males and females joy revelation, okay, like food and drink, and a host of other ones, okay, that are very obvious. But it's a big solve, okay, because these are some of the biggest words in the universe, males and females, like that applies to, and meals, like try having a joyful life without meals. Try having a joyful planet without males and females. Not of humans only, but of all the species, which provide the food chain for every species that there is, you know, not the least of which is us. And then the fact that God ordained Jerusalem to originally be called Salem, which uses the same letters as males and meals, okay, it's huge. It's a big one, okay? And then I want to give the plug for this great gem as a bonus. When you write Mr. and Mrs. in the sovereignty of God in abbreviated form, okay, in modern English, M-R-A-N-D followed by M-R-S is literally 50-50, joy, joy, in order. Because M-R followed by 19 and, or M-R followed by S is 50-50. So when Mr. and Mrs. on letterheads, envelopes, church signs, stationery, okay, the towels in the bathroom, MR and MRS equals double joy. That's another of dozens of gems in this whole arena, okay? Tons of them, okay? But I wanted to make, and I preached on this revelation a while ago, but I wanted to make a separate video titled, okay, you know, why males and females exist, because that's a big title, and we exist for the joy of God. That is the truth. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says, God himself speaking, and again, the worshipers in Revelation, they say, you are worthy to receive all glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and for thy pleasure they exist and were created. And you do the math on thy pleasure, and it's pure 25s, 5s, and 50s, screaming out joy. And we solved all those words. We've gone through it deep, okay? And we've had a bunch of follow-up words from the Lord on this, okay, that all scream out fives, like lads and lassies and other terminology for males and females. Very divine, amazing math, okay? But males and females is a huge one, because another anagram is the word meals, which have been a joy to you from the day you were born, okay? Not a day has gone, you know, and then Salem, the root of Jerusalem. And Jerusalem is such a proud word in the ordinance of God, because you read the book of Revelation, and even the heavenly city, which is to come for eternity, is called by God New Jerusalem. Okay? And so God is extremely proud of this five. Five is the number of joy. Notice that it's five letters. Okay? To spell males. Okay? And no less, that is literally M, R, S in order. The word males is M followed by 18 followed by S, which is literal M, R, S. So like I said, Mr. and Mrs. everywhere. Double joy. Okay? And, but read the book of Revelation. The fact that the New Jerusalem, so five letters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in the letters males, meals, and Salem, which equals joy, five letters that add to 50. The average value of each letter is 10 perfectly. Okay? And you can split it into three teams of fives, ML25, E5, and SA20. So easily the two half joys, 25, 25. But the word joy is three teams of fives, 10, 15, 25, going up in five. So it's just gorgeous, okay? But the fact that God ordained the new heavenly city, like the eternal city, read in the book of Revelation, to be called New Jerusalem, to end in these five letters, which are joy, okay? It's a big set of letters to make a separate video for, males and females. And as I was reading the book of Genesis all over again, okay, those words, male and female, are through and through in the first two chapters of Genesis, the whole creation story. I mean, every species, male and female, when God, you know, puts them, and when God brings them into the ark too, okay, before the flood of Noah, male and female. And huge words, massive, okay, from the beginning of the Bible. This is one of the biggest strings of God, this five letters, males. From the very beginning of Genesis, okay, which has a five at the dead center, Genesis, joy is at the center of the heart of God, okay. Males and females, God created at the very beginning, okay. By the way, this gets really deep. It was day five, the fifth day, the day of joy. Day five, as far as I, yeah, day five is the first day that the first males and females were created. The first living creatures were created. Males and females of in the waters of the sea and in the fowl of the air. Day five, the day of joy. Okay, the great joy. That's when the first males and females were created, on day five. Okay, and then mankind was created on day six with all the land animals. Okay, and but from the beginning, like this is such a huge five set of letters. Okay, so from, I encourage you to find Salem in the book of Genesis, and then go to New Jerusalem way at the end of Revelation. Okay, and of course, from the dawn of Eden, every creature has been eating meals day and night. It's like the most common thing that all males and females do in every species worldwide. Everybody eats meals for joy. So let's get this straight. God, the infinite God, the sovereign God, okay, roughly 6,000 years ago, as of this day, created everything in 6 days, as we know. On day five, He creates a hyperabundance of different species with males and females. Males and females. Human beings come on day six, made in His image, males and females. He makes a bunch of declarations about male and female and how the whole marriage order and all that. Okay? The word Salem gets introduced to mankind. Okay? Early in the chapters of Genesis, Jesus Christ appears in physical flesh. The second member of the triune God comes into physical flesh as Melchizedek, king of righteousness, to visit Abraham. And you can read that story. He's the king of Salem, which becomes Jerusalem. Okay? All through this story, from the very beginning, people have been eating meals, and the creatures have been eating meals ever since day five. Technically, when were the first meals eaten? Day five. Because that's when the creatures of the sea were created, and that's when the birds of the air were created. And what would they would have done on the day that they were created? They would have eaten. They did. Those birds were already eating on day five. The first meals, which equals 50, joy, were consumed by living creatures, males and females, on day five of the creation of this planet and the universe, okay? And that was the creatures of the sea and the birds of the air. And chances are we know the birds of the air would have been eating some of the fish of the sea as they do today. The dive bombers, those great fish grabbers that just pick them out of the water. It was awesome. Day five was full of meals, man. It was full of meals, and it was full of males and females. As the angels are crying, holy, 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 okay? And God knows that he's going to ordain a city called Salem, which equals meals, you know, and that's eventually going to become New Jerusalem, which is love, joy, okay? And that's ultimately the eternal home of all the redeemed for eternity. Like, so I'm like, that's why I'm hitting these five letters really hard. Five on the number of joy. So meals were first enjoyed by living things on day five. Everything up until that point was preparation. Okay. As a bonus for you on the Trinity in the 6 days of creation, what God did to glorify his triune nature, day one was completed on day four. Day two was completed on day five. And day three was completed on day six. It was a perfect triune pairing. Okay, day one, God creates light. Day four, he creates the bodies of light in the universe. Okay, day two, he creates, he works with the waters above and beneath in the firmament. 3 days later, he populates those two regions with the creatures of the sea and the birds of the air. Day three, he creates all the land vegetation and the stuff that the plants, the creatures of the land and the humans will consume mostly. And then 3 days later, on day six, he creates the land, beasts to eat that vegetation, and he creates us humans made in the image of God, last and all. It's a perfect three-fest. And there are many strings God ordained in English and in Hebrew Gematria that have that exact pattern. Okay, the 6 days of creation pattern, I call it, where you knit together every letter hopping in threes. Gorgeous, okay? I had to give you that gem because it's such a huge one. It's so important that you understand the Trinity and that they have a plan from the beginning to the end. And I believe it's also very, the word variety is double joy in order. I believe it's also very instructive for man to copy that in his daily life and in his working life. It's called refreshment and variety, which is key to joy. If you did something on day one, why don't you go back to that 3 days later, day four? It's the definition of giving yourself a righteous break while allowing you to continue work the next day, but do something different. Day two, return to that day five. Day three, do a third thing that's different. Come back to that on day six. Schools in particular can replicate this very easily. Switching subjects, coming back, anyone. Builders, farmers, anyways. Seriously. Okay, so back to the meals thing. We're just hitting out of the park. So Salem comes along. Jerusalem gets born. Jesus Christ introduces Salem, the second member of the Trinity. And to this day, okay, people still say Salem everywhere. While everyone's eating their meals, and males and females are everywhere. And then go to the end of Revelation. And New Jerusalem, the heavenly city, the eternal city, okay, ends in the Great Salem, the Great Meals. It's practically the word males / meals spelled backwards, Salem. It's just, it's like God, you know, declares the beginning from the end. It's like at the beginning of creation, it's males and meals. At the end, it's New Jerusalem. The letter's almost going backwards. It's like from the beginning to the end, it's the joy of God, okay, in this whole story, okay? If I was to try and count, these words are so big. If I was to try and count the number of males and females of all species that have existed since the dawn of Eden just over 6,000 years ago, it would be impossible. It would be in the quintillions, the trillions of trillions. And if I was subsequently to try and count the number of meals that have been consumed by all the males and females, it would be even higher, okay? And if I was to try and even start to talk about the glory of New Jerusalem, which is the heavenly city forever and ever for all eternity, that would take me all eternity to talk about. That's how proud God is of these five letters, M-A-L-E-S. They were there at the very beginning, and they're there at the very end for all eternity. And they're there all the way through the middle. Every day, you eat meals. Every day, you run into males and females. Okay? And for all eternity, you live in a city that was originally called Salem. It's ultimately called Jerusalem, which now is love, joy, in order. It's that big. Okay, and there's a ton of follow-up gems with this that all divide by five. I've mentioned some of them in a previous video, but Just get that one. I encourage you to do it on paper. Males and females. 50, and then in the middle there's beautiful fives. AN15, DF10, E5, going down in fives perfectly. It's just total confirmation from the Lord. Okay, that adds 30 points in the middle. And then females, of course, ends in males. Okay, so the whole thing is 130, pure five. Five, the number of joy. And I give you some extra bonus artillery there. It was day five, okay, that the first males and females were created and the first meals were eaten. And then I encourage you, you will be amazed, okay? God created a garden in Eden. A garden equals joy perfectly. Letter for letter, a garden equals joy equals meals. The garden was not just a beauty to behold. It was a beauty to eat, as the Bible says. Garden equals joy. A garden equals joy, letter for letter, perfectly. We did that in previous video. A-D-E equals J, A-N equals O, G-R equals Y. Who created the garden? The Lord. Lord equals garden, letter for letter, in the matching, okay? But now I encourage you to compare the letters a garden to meals, and I'll bet you can get almost a flawless letter for letter construction as well. What was one of the major purposes of a garden? And to this day, why do people grow a garden? Because they want meals. They want the healthiest meals they can have. We could even do it right now. I mean, this is so big, this word meals. Like, and by the way, the word food divides by five. It equals us. F-O-U-O-D-S. Food equals 40. Joy. Okay? The great title of God, us. Now let's take a look at a garden versus meals. You have an A, you have an E, and then it's up to you to try and knit together the rest. And I don't know if you can get a letter correlation. I'm not too concerned if you can or cannot. It's close. I can already tell in my mind. It's very similar, like an R is off by one from an S. You know, very similar, okay? Very obvious though, okay? And then I encourage you, as I might do, to go to the very end of your Bible now, okay, to the book of Revelation, and find all the instances of New Jerusalem near the end chapters, and do treasure hunting for fives and for joy, and you will not be disappointed. As a deep Hebrew bonus for you, the very last word of the very last letter of your entire Bible, and in all the Hebrew scripture, the word Amen in Hebrew ends in the Hebrew letter, which is 50, which we know in English is joy. And I've done Hebrew Gematria. Hebrew Gematria is so loaded with fives, it's embarrassing. But the very last letter, okay, of your Bible is 50, Amen, okay, preceded by a 40, okay, and then a 1. And then we talked about everlasting joy. They lived happily ever after. Ever after is joy, joy. Okay, and happily begins with joy and ends in up, and and then everlasting life is joy, joy, life, life in symmetry. Ever is joy, ting is joy, and then life is at the center of everlasting. Eternal is half a joy, joy in order. It's very obvious. Okay, the five letters on the end of eternal, which equals joy, are very similar to the word meals again. Very similar, okay? You have an E and an A and an L, and then the R and the N differ from a single point up and down from the M and the S. Very obvious what God is saying about things eternal. It's eternal joy, folks, okay? Males and females, okay? Huge, huge stuff. So I wanted to make a separate video for that because this is massive, okay? From the dawn of Eden, day five, it was males and females, joy, consuming meals, daily joy, and we ultimately go home to a city that was originally called Salem, using the same letters, joy, and it's Jerusalem, which is love joy. Okay, and there's much evidence in the Bible to declare that most people believe that there will be animals in heaven, but that is very secondary to the fact that you need to be there. Okay, and so how do you get in there? The Bible says if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You will be forgiven of all your sins, past, present, and future, because of what Jesus did on the cross. Okay? So do that right now if you've never done that. Okay? And as soon as you do that, know that your name is written in heaven permanently, forever, the book of life. Okay? God himself comes and lives inside of you by his spirit. You will feel the peace. Okay? You are forgiven. You are holy permanently. Okay? By the blood of Jesus. And but there you go. Huge. Males, females. Awesome. Okay? Very, very, very awesome.